Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Kurt, and welcome back to Kerbal Space Program. Indeed, here we are, floating away from any sort of spacecraft of any description, high above Kerbin, in orbit, in our spacesuits. No, not really. This is just the opening screen, but we're back in Kerbal Space Program. How do you guys like the new intro? It was a little bit too overdramatic. I think it's a humorous, dramatic entry in music for such a not-so-dramatic game. But yeah, we're back in Kerbal Space Program, and, you know, the last time we flew on an aeroplane within the atmosphere to the North Pole and landed. Our guys are still hanging out up there. Today we're going to do something a little bit more orbit and space-related. I figured since we conquered winged flight, we should apply that knowledge to space flight and set forth the Kerbal Space Program Space Shuttle Initiative. So we're going to go ahead and test out some designs, just go through the design process and the trial and what I'm assuming is going to be plenty of error. So let's start by getting into the VAB and making a design here. All right, here is our first space shuttle design. It's pretty much taking the space shuttle design that we know and love from the real world. We're basically taking a very similar design that we used in our aircraft to get to the North Pole. Similar features, obviously we don't have the jet engines because we're not going to need those to get into space and to get back from space. We're just going to glide in. We have our external tank, which feeds to the main tank here for the main engines. We have our two solid rocket boosters and our three main space shuttle main engines. And then these orbital maneuvering units right here. I have the main engines going off first in terms of the sequence, and then the two solid rocket boosters. I've just thrown this together pretty haphazardly, I guess is the word for it. I'm not sure how to go about it. I've also had to add, and this is a problem where the old parts aren't really syncing in with the new parts, I had to add an RCS fuel pod at the back here because I have these. I had to have some way to maneuver in orbit, assuming we even get there. So I've added RCS thrusters to the nose, just like our real space shuttle. Obviously, the real space shuttle doesn't have these front canards, but I need that for stability, as we found out that those were quite helpful in our flight to the North Pole. But yeah, I think everything's all set up here. I've also set up... Where did they go? Oh, did I do that wrong? No, okay, yeah, I don't know if this is going to make a difference, but I put parachutes on the solid rocket boosters like we do in real NASA space shuttle. But then I also have... there they are. I put them on the bottom. I also have parachutes on the wings of our space shuttle, which will help us come to a smooth stop at what I'm assuming is going to be a breakneck speed we come to the landing area from orbit. But yeah, let's head to the space shuttle. Let's head to the launch pad over there. I've dubbed this space shuttle Kerbin Rise after our first space shuttle Enterprise, which was just a mock-up, never went to space, but there's a little bit of trivia for you. That one's over, they've moved that one to the Intrepid Air and Space Museum in New York. Oh, and we're here. That setup is a little bit not what I was expecting, to be honest, but I guess that makes sense. I think the wing might clip the tower if we were rotated the other way. But we're here, we don't have anybody important in the pilot seat, so it's okay if we don't have a successful flight. For some reason, well, I guess by default, the gear is always up, so let's retract the gear. Let's enable our SAS. It doesn't seem to do anything. Let's throttle up. My prediction, my guess, is going to be that we're going to have a little bit of an imbalanced flight here, simply because things are imbalanced. So I'm either going to tilt to the back or to the front. Hopefully it's to the back and away from the launch pad, the launch tower. Why is that lighting up when I select it? That's weird. Oh, I guess that's just not lighting up when I select it. That's just... Anyway, graphical glitches. But yeah, Johnson, Tom, and Gregsky, Kerman, good luck, and I'm glad I didn't really get to know you guys, because just good luck. All right, we're going to light the main engines, and then we are going to light the solid rocket boosters and at the same time drop our support. So, without further ado, in 3, 2, main engine starts, and booster ignition, and exactly as anticipated. Okay. Things are happening. Let's cut the engines and try to get these parachutes to deploy. There we go. Got the parachutes. Perhaps... Oh, good lord. Perhaps we can save our guys. Well, this is an interesting way to... Oh, god. We're going to hit cockpit first. Careful! Brace for impact. Oh, they survived. Those explosions are really loud. I have the volume, like, down to 2%, but the explosions apparently do not follow the wishes of the settings. They survived! Anyway, they survived. So let's, what happened there? Obviously, the space shuttle side of it was too powerful, so we tilted forward. So I think if we end the flight and head back to the vehicle assembly building... perhaps if we replace these three engines with the least powerful engines... Symmetry. There we go. That's another thing. In building this, I know I didn't record that, but in building this, it's very difficult because symmetry doesn't work at all. Even really putting on the wing... Well, the wings, I guess it worked, but beyond that, symmetry was not being helpful at all. But yeah, there's our engines. Let's actually make those... Where'd they go? They went way up here. No, I want you to be down at the bottom. Alright, let's... do one of these guys, and then have them light off first. Very nice. Yeah, okay. Well, let's try this out. Slight modification. It's all trial and error. It's all good. We have unlimited resources right now because this is just the beta version of the game, or alpha version of the game. So let's head back to the launch pad. And we're back. And Johnson, Tom, and Gregsky have all volunteered for this second trial. Which might not have been the greatest of ideas. Oh, look at the moonrise. And the sun in the middle of the sky. Interesting. All right. Well, this is going to be a picturesque... Put the gear up. A picturesque takeoff, regardless of what happens. So let's just do away with the pleasantries of a countdown and start the main engines. Very nice. Let me just check. The fuel is draining. Yeah, the fuel's draining where I want it to. Okay, so that's good. All right, so now let's see if our solid rocket boosters are too powerful. In 3, 2, 1... Yep, they are. They're too powerful. Uh-oh. Good grief with the explosions. Yeah. Okay. Now I can... And I suppose I could... These weren't firing. I was saving these for on-orbit operations, but I could have these fire, and maybe they will cancel out the power from the solid rocket boosters. So I think we should give that a try before we start to take any sort of more drastic measures of redesign to the space shuttle system. So let's head back to the launch pad once more, see what astronauts we have today. We've got Kenwell, Mackley, and Nedney. Good old Nedney. Let's do that. Let's enable the SAS. We've got our throttle up, and main engine start. Seems to be a lot of power that comes out of those top engines. And let's see what happens when we light the old solid rocket boosters. Nope. Okay. Oh! a picture-perfect liftoff. Nothing went wrong at all. That's interesting. Since we're flying, although we are sucking down the fuel pretty good, since we're flying, I guess we could kind of test out the gliding abilities of this design. Under powered flight, it seems pretty stable. Seems like it's doing a good job. Let me get some altitude and see if I can actually... Let me turn off the SAS. See if I can actually... Okay, let's turn the SAS back on. See if I can actually do anything useful. Oh, we're about to run out of fuel, so I guess we're going to find out how much of a glider this thing is. So far, so good. Easy. Oh, gosh. Okay, I've screwed us over. Sorry, guys. Oh, crap. Oh, dear. All right, hold that. SAS. Good job, good job. The SAS has saved us. Perhaps. Pull up. Pull up. Why are we not pulling up? Pull up. I don't want to turn off the SAS. I'm going to totally lose control again. Oh, we're pulling up. Okay. Okay. Let's, 200 feet. 200 meters, actually. Okay. Okay. Let's actually put down the landing gear, just in case. 100 meters. Oh, God. Okay. This might be our landing run. Alright. Easy, easy, easy. Easy. Oh, okay, we're actually gliding again. That's interesting. I'm not going to make it back to the runway, so this is what we're going to land on. I'm not touching anything. This is totally autopilot. All right, let's lower the nose a little bit so we actually do start coming down. We have control over this landing. Very nice. Oh, that was a parachute. Sorry, maybe it was too close to the landing gear. Oops. Oh, there's the parachutes. Okay. Well, as I suspected, this design is a sound glider, and that, I guess, fulfills the duties. Oh, although we're sinking in the quicksand. That fulfills the duties as Space Shuttle Enterprise did. Enterprise was kind of the glider, the glide test, just to make sure the Space Shuttle design would fly in real life. But I did put a crew ladder here, as I did with the other aircraft that went to the North Pole. And netting could fall out. Well done, guy. Whew, you survived. Well, good piloting you did there at the end. Swagger away. Oh god, I don't think I've gotten this close to them before. Oh, that's freaky. Okay, let's get him back in the spacecraft and then we'll end the flight. But I think that was a successful failure. We lost all of our outboard engines. I wonder, in my duties to let you guys know more about what's coming up in the game. They've posted on the forums their plans for, this is 1.6, or 0.16. For 0.17, they're looking at, among other things, adding visual cues for the center of gravity. So whenever you add a part, there will be a position that says, okay, the center of gravity of your spacecraft is here, 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 or here. In this situation, I'm assuming it's way out of whack, which is our problem. I'm starting to think, since we were too overpowered on the space shuttle side and tilting towards the fuel tank, the belly side, let's take a look at the statistics. This has a thrust of 80, and these have a thrust of 20. Maybe I should only try to launch with these and not the three main engines. Could be a possibility. Let's actually do that. Let's disable these until Oh, let's actually make a new stage here. Where should I put this? Let's put it before we release the external fuel tank so we can actually use that extra fuel. But yeah, let's do that. So now we're going to try lifting off with only these outer, what are they called? Radial mount liquid engine, the Mark 55. So yeah, let's try that. And then see which direction that points us from there. Clear the pad. But yeah, the rate at which these two fuel tanks went down with those rockets was a little bit alarming, so we'll see what we can do here. All right, we got our guys back. You guys did a magical time flying in the last 10 minutes ago. We have a very quick turnaround here at Kerbal Space Center. Let's try this again. Let's light up the two main engines, just those guys, and then let's light up the solid rocket boosters in 3, 2, 1. Still, whoa. And it's not gonna have the same luck. Good grief. Hold on, I'm gonna go back and check the volume settings, because that's insane, the explosions. That's a very, very robust cockpit that you guys got there. And even the very robust, what are those things called? The front aileron doohickeys. Alright guys, we are back, and we're looking at another rendition of the Space Shuttle Kerbal Prize. And what I've done is I've positioned these pods closer to the center, as opposed to so high up. Maybe that'll make a difference. Oh, they don't appear to be on straight, but I'm going to assume they're stuck there. Then I've moved these over the wings. Hopefully that works well. So let's head to the launch pad and try out this once again. Try out this once again, or try this out once again. You know, Yoda speak, or whatever that was. Oh, we got new astronauts. What happened to our other guys? Are they still somewhere out there? Yeah, oops. They're still hanging out in the debris. Just sit back and watch this one, guys. But yeah, let's try this out with Ferdinand, Sidson, and Wilsel. Wilsel. Let's put the gear up. Let's throttle up. Start those engines. And oh, get. A little bit better. Hold that. Okay. Oh, we're going up. Brilliant. Let's, I forgot to turn on the SAS. Let's get back on our center line. Oh, roll program! Alright, we're back on our center line and the SAS is on. Okay! We're going somewhere, guys. I feel like I should enable these. Yep, I should have enabled those. Crap! Oh god. Oh lord. Hold on. Oh dear. the G-forces apparently ripped our aircraft apart. Interesting. Okay. Let's, watch the debris crash, first of all. Explosions. Okay, now we can end the flight. Let's head back to the vehicle assembly building. That worked out surprisingly okay. So what I'm gonna do is, what do I have these up here? I'm gonna actually have these ignite third, so that once I do get some sort of proper vector, we can then enable these rockets, which will maybe stabilize us in our vertical ascent. So let's head back to the launch pad. Trial and error, folks. Trial and error. Now we've got Patry, Jorlong, and Tomlin. Okay, let's not forget to enable the SAS this time. Gear up. Main engine start, and liftoff. Watch that. Oh, God, that's so close. All right, let's get back vertically, please. Okay. And then right as the external solid rocket boosters are going to burn out is when I'm going to fire the remaining three main engines. I've got some nice sparkler effects coming off of the solid rockets. Okay, let's start those engines now. Didn't help. Did not help at all. Yeah. Oh, gosh. I should learn to just turn off the engines when that starts happening. Oh. Sorry. Sorry, guys. Oh. Oh, I was trying to look around to see if I could see the debris, but apparently you cannot. Back at the launch pad. So, guys, what's up? I'm assuming those particles will start falling down, or they just disappeared. I think they just disappeared. Anyway, That is an interesting conundrum. Let me get those guys out of their aircraft, actually. Let's end that flight. Go to the tracking station. Our guys are still hanging out at the North Pole. Those guys are still hanging out in the middle of the Earth there. So let's... Space Shuttle, let's get to these guys and actually end their flight to get them out of their boredom. Ooh. Let's end this flight to get them out of the way. I'm sure they're thrilled after the two flights they just saw. Not sure how to correct for that. I'm going to try one more thing. Maybe these engines aren't powerful enough, and I will replace them once again with these engines. Where did they go in the sequence? Maybe that's the way to do it. I actually want them right there. No, not the parachutes. And actually, you know what? Screw these parachutes. They're just adding weight where I don't need them. Although now that's totally going to probably screw up the symmetry that I've so sorely fought to get. So anyway, let's head to the launch pad and see who we have this time in the cockpit. Kenwell, Maisley, and Ned Dean. Didn't I just kill you guys? Are you guys the ones that just got off that other mission? Who knows? We've already forgotten. All right, gear up, SAS on, main engine start, throttle all the way up, booster ignition, a surprisingly vertical liftoff. Let's not get our hopes up, but that was pretty amazing. Roll program. Very nice. I wish I could do this roll program a little bit better. Okay. This is the most amazing flight we've seen thus far. I'm gonna pitch back just a little bit. Oh no. Oh, wait. Oh, I tried to save them. I'm so sorry. I hit X, but too late. It's probably that weight in the front there, that big ol' honkin' weight, the external fuel tank that's making me lean over to the front. So I'm going to, let me go to the vehicle assembly building and let me think about modifying this design a little bit. So I'll be back with you un momento. Alright guys, we are back, and we've got a new space shuttle system here. Went a little bit overboard. This is Space Shuttle Kerbantis, such like Atlantis. I've changed a little things. I figured, even though we did get that straight liftoff, what did I do here? I accidentally had the symmetry on when I built this. Dang it! Let's try that again. I didn't scrap our design per se. It was just more of a reimagining is what this is. Where is that part? There it is right there. Okay. A reimagining, if you will. There. Same, pretty much the same setup in terms of the orbiter. I have moved that SAS fuel up to the top. It just looks better and makes more sense. So we've done that. I've also, in a bid to make a little bit more symmetry, I've turned these into liquid fuel rockets. They tend to last longer than those solid fuel rockets do. I think that was a problem I was having with those solid rockets. So I've changed the boosters into liquid fuel boosters. And I've also given an engine, this might be ill-advised in terms of our fuel consumption, but I've given an engine to the fuel tank here, which hopefully, once these guys disconnect, should balance us out. And I've set up the fuel lines so that everything drains from these outside. So these are going to drain first, and I'll still have full fuel tanks here. And I also put, instead of this double fuel tank, just a single fuel tank on the bottom. Sorry, neighbors are back. The garage door is now open. For those of you who didn't hear that grinding noise. Damn it. All right, let's just assume that that was these helpful engineers and construction people working on the space shuttle system. But without further ado, let's head to the launch pad and see what this puppy can do. All right, here we are. And it looks a little bit more small and stubby. But it's not the size that matters, as you know. It is how quickly the thing spins around and crashes back into the ground. But now we've got Buzz Kerman. Buzz Kerman? That's awesome that they named one of them Buzz. Herfert and Dudzel Kerman. Buzz, good luck. Perhaps one day you will land on the moon. But not today, that's for sure. So yeah, let's... Oh. I might have set something up here wrong. Oh, okay. No, that's right. Okay. Let's light these engines. Let's turn on the SAS. Okay, that's a lot of power. And the external boosters. Oh, we seem to have the opposite problem. Oh, dear. Let's, there doesn't seem to... Oh. how's it going, guys? Yeah. We're just gonna get into orbit this way. Okay. This is interesting. All the blood is rushing to their heads, but it works. I'm trying to pull down, I guess would be the word for it. Pull down, even though that's technically up. We're gonna go into a polar orbit at this heading. This is an interesting development indeed. Things should rapidly change once I lose these boosters. Either things will even themselves out, or they will go terribly, terribly wrong. I'm considering perhaps we should just not disconnect the boosters until we're at a higher altitude. But things are about to... Okay, there that goes. Okay. Curious. Curious indeed. Oh, they hit the wings. Okay. Alright, let's let the SAS try to correct for that. Try. And fail. Aye. Garumba. Oh, God. Okay. Alright, SAS off. Let's get this under control ourselves. I'm actually gonna throttle down just because that's getting a little crazy. Okay. Alright. We have control of the aircraft, spacecraft, sort of. We do not seem to have the necessary control to lift and avoid the impending ocean. Okay, I had to do it. It's more like a missile than anything. That's pretty awesome. Alright. Okay. Well, this certainly changes things a little bit. Let's just see what we can do from this perspective. Assuming not much, but let's see what kind of altitude we can get. now I have the opposite problem. So maybe I should take that third engine off of the external fuel tank to get things a little bit more even. I think that's probably the thing we'll have to do in the next try. But, yeah, we're not really gaining any sort of speed or altitude with this. Alright, so I'm going to actually head back to the landing. The old vitamin barn. The landing strip. And try things out from there. I mean, I suppose the problem I'm having is that I'm trying to emulate a real-world space shuttle with the three engines and the boosters and the external tank, and just the symmetry of it all is not going to allow me to do such things. So I might have to rethink the entire program altogether. That was an interesting flight. But I guess before I do that, I should try out the variation without that middle rocket, and then we'll see how that works. But without that, it tends to go very, very wrong when we disconnect or we lose the outboard booster rockets. Things tend to get really, really out of whack. So I think I'm going to try to make the runway here. I just want to get on a better approach. Whoa, that SAS really helps us stay stable. This is not having any of this. Alright, very nice, very nice. Let's try to gain a little bit of altitude. Very nice. Also slow us down. Alright, let's make our big left-hand bank here. You can do it, Buzz. You can do it. Okay, that was a little bit too much. Whoa! Okay, that didn't work. Ooh, hello! Okay. Let's cut the old engines to actually do this the right way as a glider. Let's put the gear down. Easy. Easy. Lining up with this runway certainly is an issue. Alright, let's give ourselves a little power, because I feel like I'm dropping pretty quick. Alright. Let's see if we can line up properly here. Okay, cut the engines. That's too much power. Okay. Flare the nose up. Okay, I panicked. We don't have that much runway left. Crap. I panicked again. Parachutes! Woo! Whoa! Wheelie! And the brakes. Hey! If anything, that was my first successful landing back at the landing strip. That's a difficult thing to do on such short notice, but I think it was from the help of Buzz Kerbin, perhaps. Ah, indeed. Okay, well, this design works, it just doesn't work. So I'm going to head back to the VAB, and we're going to see if we can just make a few minor adjustments, and then see about lifting off once again. Alright, I'm back, and that actually didn't take long. What I've done, instead of having... I had the most powerful rocket there, the LV-T-30. I've replaced it with the least powerful rocket, the LV-909. Which has far less thrust, but I'm thinking it would be good just to have that there in order to just balance things out perhaps a little bit. I don't know, I could be completely wrong, but let's try this one more time to see if we can't have any sort of success. To the launch pad! Buzz, Hufert, and Dutzel are back. Let's put the gear up. SAS on. Throttle up. Oh, crap, I don't think I... did the staging of this rocket properly when I added it. Where are you at? No, I did not. Yeah, let's take that guy, move it down there. Ah! Adjusting the flight computer at the launch pad. but yeah, let's light those engines. All right. And in 3, 2, 1, let's light the boosters. Oh, not enough power at all. All right. Oh, gosh. Oh, dear. Oh, gosh. Oh, okay. Everything's fine. Everything's just fine. Don't worry about anything. Yeah. That is interesting. I almost feel like making one of them and go on EVA and then just walk away from the rubble. Oh, now I have to do that. Okay. It's gotta be Buzz. You know it's gotta be Buzz. They can survive that fall, can't they? I guess we'll find out. Buzz? EVA? Oh god. Ow. Yay! Amazing. Walking away from the wreckage. Oh, wait, I gotta get this for the thumbnail. Alright. Great. Hold on, I gotta get a better angle on this. How do you make the extra stuff go away? Is it like F2 or something? Yeah, F2, okay. Aw, oh, dang, this isn't working out too well. Ah, this game. Everything's fine. Our space shuttle flight systems are running along smoothly. Oh, God, don't mess things up there, Buzz. I'm gonna start making more explosions, and I don't know what happens when you're outside of the spacecraft while explosions are going on. There we go. Well done. Good job. Boop. There's the screenshot right there. Well done, guys. Well done. Yes, any flight that you can walk away from is a success in Kerbal Space Program. Indeed. I'm not sure what to try here, guys. I think for one of the first times in history, I'm going to have to go look at the forums or other suggestions, other videos to see the best practices for creating a space shuttle system. I suppose an idea would be to have, like we have our fuselage up here, instead of putting rocket parts on the other side, put another fuselage on the other side, obviously without the capsule, which should balance out the weight to, you know, on either side, the weight ratio thing, and then put the same amount of engines on the other side and everything. That might be the best way to do it. But I would like to create something that actually looks like a space shuttle, but who knows? I think we're going to have to wait till the next episode of Kerbal Space Program to find out, but thank you very much for watching this episode. My name is Kurt. His name is Buzz. Thanks so much for watching. We will see you next time. Oh, punk.